Now you say, why would you even make this video? Why even take the time to go through all these verses and debunk them? I'll tell you why. I am defending the Word of God. You see, Satan would love for people to think that the Bible teaches that the earth is flat because the vast majority of people are smart enough to know that it's not flat. So then when they hear that the Bible teaches that it's flat, it causes them to just reject the Bible out of hand. You know, when my wife was unsaved, she was raised in Germany, and she thought that the Bible taught that, you know, that, oh, the earth's flat and all this stuff. And it caused her to just have zero interest in the Bible because she just thought, oh, the Bible is scientifically full of it. So therefore, why would I listen to it? You know, then when I met her, I showed her, no, the Bible teaches that the earth is round, you know, it's a sphere, hell's in the heart of the earth. And I showed her, you know, Leviticus 15 about how God knew way more about sanitation and cleanliness and all the science behind that long before man had discovered that. I showed her where he hangs the earth on nothing. I showed her all this scientifically accurate stuff in the Bible. Then she was actually open to hearing what the Bible says. But these flat earthers are doing the work of Satan to basically make the Bible look stupid. And that's what you're doing if you're one of these flat earth people. You're going around making the Bible look stupid, and literally people will go to hell because of this kind of deception where people won't even listen to the Bible anymore. For example, I had several people that I know personally come up to me and say, well, the Quran teaches that the earth is flat. Several people said that to me. And I went and fact-checked it, and guess what? The Quran does not say that the earth is flat. Now, the Quran's a stupid book for other reasons, but it didn't say that. But the vast majority of people who are Christians, when they hear that the Quran teaches that the earth is flat, they just automatically believe it. It's like, oh yeah, the Quran's stupid. Well, that's what the worldly people are doing. When they hear that the Bible teaches the earth is flat, they're just like, oh, well, the Bible's stupid then. People have known that the earth is round for thousands of years, okay? People have been studying astronomy. If you look at ancient history, if you look at old artifacts and archaeology, people have always been very into astronomy, and they did all the calculations even thousands and thousands of years ago and have always known the earth is round. It's only idiots in the Dark Ages who thought that it was flat, okay, 500 years ago. It was just a bunch of Dark Age buffoons who thought that, okay, and Roman Catholics and so stuff that were teaching that. As part of their way of keeping people in darkness in the Middle Ages. But before that, people knew it was round, and after that, people knew it was round. It's that simple. But honestly, my message to you, if you have been sucked into this flat earth thing, is to repent of the wicked sin of foolishness. Over and over again, God says that foolishness is a sin. And foolishness means stupidity. Don't be stupid here. Don't be a tool of Satan promoting this garbage. There are the people who are behind it. I think the people who make these videos, like the 75 Bible verses or this Rob Skiba or whatever his name is, these people are evil people. They don't even believe it's flat. They're just doing this to do the work of Satan, just to make asses out of God's people, make them all look like fools. And he's doing a pretty good job making people look like retards. You say, why are you so harsh about this? Look, because I hate every false way. It makes me angry to hear the Word of God blasphemed. And every time you say the Bible teaches that the earth is flat, you are being blasphemous. You are making a mockery of the Word of God, and you need to repent of your stupidity and foolishness and quit making a mockery of the holy, eternal Word of God that is perfect in every way. And I'm here to defend the Bible and say, no, the Bible does not teach this stupidity, because there are people out there that are smart enough to know that it's round. And when they hear you say that stupidity, then they're going to turn around and say, oh, the Bible's stupid. No, the Bible's not stupid. You're stupid. And you need to get some smarts and quit talking about things you don't understand. And you need to actually learn math and science before you start trying to talk about math and science. And you need to start learning the Bible before you start talking about the Bible. Because knowing the fact that the ends of the earth is referring to the ends of the dry land, that's pretty basic. You know, so if you can't figure that out, then honestly, you need to keep your mouth shut. And so I feel strongly about this because of the fact that I feel that it's blaspheming my Savior. It's blaspheming the Word of God. And, you know, a lot of people would say, don't even make this video. Why do you even address it? It makes you look stupid. Well, you know what? I'm willing to look stupid by addressing it, because it is, you know, you answer a fool according to his folly, and people think you're like unto him. But you know what? I'm willing to do that because of the fact that there are so many videos on YouTube, hundreds of thousands of views, where people are being sucked into this mass psyop, this mass campaign of deception to make Christians look like fools. So, you know, somebody, it's a dirty job, but somebody's got to do it.